Welcome to my lecture. Today we are going to solve a tutorial problem in engine force analysis considering the mass of connecting rod. Let me read the problem. The connecting rod of a vertical reciprocating engine is 2 meter long between centers and it weighs 250 kilogram. The mass center is 800 mm from the big end bearing. When suspended as a pendulum from the gudgeon pin axis, it makes 8 complete oscillations in 22 seconds. Calculate the radius of gyration of the rod about an axis through its mass center. The crank is 400 mm long and rotates at 200 rpm. Find the torque exerted on the crankshaft when the crank has turned through 40 degrees from top dead center and the piston is moving downwards direction. Okay, so this is what the problem. This is what the configuration diagram of the given system. Okay, vertical reciprocating engine. Okay, so and this is what the top dead center and this is what the bottom dead center. So here this is the point where the piston started. So it is a TDC and here it is the extreme end. At that point it is bottom dead center at this point. Okay, now let us just write down the given data. Okay, the first thing is the length of the connecting rod is 2 meter and the mass of the connecting rod is 250 kilogram. Okay, and the distance between mass center and the big end bearing, so it is very clearly mentioned that the distance between big end bearing and the mass center. Okay, so we all know that the big end bearing is here, so this is where the position of big end bearing and this is the mass center, the point G. So this distance is given. Okay, so this distance is given and that is 800 mm. okay, so this distance is given and it is 800 mm. So here we have converted that into meter, 0.8 meter. So we have to convert this length into L1. So L1 is the distance between the point P, that means from this point to mass center. So this is the L1. So if I want to find out the L1, I need to subtract this 800 mm from the length of the connecting rod. Okay, so the L1 can be found by using this relation, L minus GC. GC is the distance that is given, which is 0.8 meter. So the L1 value is 1.2 meter. Okay. The next value which is given is the radius of the crank. Okay, the radius of the crank is 0.4 meter. And the speed of the crank is 200 rpm. And theta is the angle turned by the crank from top dead center and it is 40 degree. Okay. So what are the things we are going to calculate? Okay. The first thing is, so unlike previous problem, here we are not provided with the value of radius of gyration. Okay. Instead, we are asked to calculate the radius of gyration. Okay. The first question is, we have to calculate the radius of gyration. Okay. And the second thing is, we have to calculate what is the torque exerted on the crankshaft. Okay. So we all know that it is a combination of these three torques. Okay. T1, T2, T3. T1 represents the torque due to piston effort. T2 is the torque due to correction couple. T3 is the torque due to mass placed at the crank pin. Fine. Okay. The other data which are given in the problems are, when suspended as a pendulum from the gudgeon pin axis, it makes 8 complete oscillations in 22 seconds. Okay. So by using this data, we can calculate the frequency of the connecting rod. Okay. So by using that, we can calculate the radius of gyration. Okay. This is what the thing we are going to do as far as this data is concerned. Okay. Now let us solve the problem. The first thing is, we are going to calculate the torque due to the piston effort. Okay. So I just drawn this vertical engine And we all know that the piston effort is FL minus FI plus MRG. Okay, so as far as vertical engine is concerned, okay, so we have to add this term. Okay, so this term is not relevant as far as horizontal engine is concerned. Okay, this term is only considered for vertical engine. Okay, fine. So now we are going to calculate this inertia force, because we are not provided any data relevant to this one, that is FL, okay, the load due to gas pressure. So we are not provided any data relevant to this FL, so we can just consider that as zero. So the next term is inertia force. Okay, we know that inertia force is
MP
plus M1 omega square r cos theta plus cos 2 theta divided by n. Okay, so in this I want to know what is the value of M1, omega and n. Okay, if I know these values, then I can find out what is the inertia force is. Okay, so here omega is 2 pi n by 60. We can calculate this value, which is 20.94 radian per second, and n is the ratio between length of the connecting rod to the radius of cram, and it is 5. And M1 value is L minus L1 divided by L MC. Okay, so this is the formula which is used to find out the M1. Okay, and this value is 100 kilogram. So we know that the mass M1 is going to be placed at the piston. Okay, and M2 is supposed to be placed at the crank pin. Okay, the M1 plus M2 is equal to the mass of the connecting rod. Okay, so that we all know as far as placing these two masses is concerned. Okay, we are going to divide the connecting rod mass into two elements, M1, M2. One is supposed to be placed at this point, piston, and another one is to be placed at the crank pin. Okay, so M1 value is calculated and it is 100 kilogram. So I can substitute this value here. Okay, I have just put this value as zero. Okay, reason is I'm not given any data relevant to the piston. Okay, since the piston mass is not provided. Okay, so here I'm going to take this value as zero. Okay, if the mass of the piston is given, then I have to consider the mass of the piston. Okay, then I have to add these two things together, but this problem the mass of the piston is not given, so I'm just going to ignore that. I'm just going to put that as zero. Okay, other times I have just substituted the values and I just found the inertia force is 14,045.05 newton. Okay, so this is what the inertia force. Okay, so now I'm just going to calculate the piston effort. Okay, so by substituting this value in this relations. Okay, that is piston effort relations. Okay, so here we know that the piston mass is not provided, but anyhow at piston we have a connecting rod mass. A part of the connecting rod mass is supposed to be on the piston. Okay, so MR value is not completely zero. That means the combined effect is 100 kilogram. Okay, so the MR value is 100 kilogram. Okay, so 100 multiplied by 9.81. okay, so this is the term. I'm just going to replace for this term, that is the MRG. okay, the piston effort is 13,064 newton. So here this is very important to denote that direction. Okay, because the direction plays vital role in finding the direction of the torque. Okay, whether it is clockwise or counterclockwise. Okay, so here the system is accelerating because the theta is 40 degree. Okay, so the inertia force is supposed to be in the opposite direction. Okay, so this is the direction of the inertia force. Okay, so here this mass, that is the mass of the reciprocating parts, that is mass of the piston plus M1. Okay, so the entire mass multiplied by G. Okay, since mass of the piston is not given, I'm going to consider only M1G here. So that is why I've just put 100 times 9.81. So it is supposed to be acting in the downwards direction because it is a weight due to
gravity. So only two forces are there as far as piston is concerned. So the inertia force is acting in the upward direction. Okay, if it is acting in the upward direction, then it is going to create a counterclockwise moment. Okay, that is what the basic idea in determining the direction of the torque. Okay, if it is moving in the upward direction, that is Fp is in the upward direction, then this torque which is produced at the crankshaft is counterclockwise direction. Okay, so this direction is very important. We don't need to mention plus or minus like that. Okay, so we need to give a proper direction for the piston effort. Okay, it is going to be in the upward direction. What is the torque due to the piston effort? Okay, so for that we can use this formula, that is T1 is Fp divided by cos pi sine theta plus phi multiplied by R. Okay, this is the formula which is used to calculate the torque due to the piston effort. Okay, so here I need to know the value of phi. Okay, so for that I can apply this relation, sine phi is equal to sine theta divided by n. So the phi value can be found as 7.38 degree. Okay, by applying this value, I know the other values, that is Fp or theta values are known. So I can calculate this value of torque 1, okay, which is due to the piston effort, and it is 3877.4 Newton meter. Okay, and the direction is counterclockwise direction because the piston effort is in the upward direction. Okay, so here there are two forces, Fi and the weight of the reciprocating parts. So the dominant force is Fi, so the direction of the piston effort must be in the upward direction. Since it is in the upward direction, okay, so it is going to create a counterclockwise moment. Okay, so about this point it's just going to create a counterclockwise moment. Okay, if it is in the downwards direction, okay, then it is going to create a clockwise moment. Okay, as far as this point is concerned, so for our case it is in the upward direction, so it is going to create a counterclockwise moment about this point O. Okay, so that is why here it is put as counterclockwise. Okay, so now we have calculated the torque due to the piston effort. Okay, fine. Next we are going to calculate the torque due to correction couple. Okay, so before finding the torque due to the correction couple, we have to find out the radius of gyration of the connecting rod. Okay, so that is very important. Without knowing the radius of gyration, we cannot calculate that torque due to correction couple. Okay, so the natural frequency of any system can be found by knowing the number of cycles and the time taken to complete that number of cycles. Okay, so here we are going to consider this connecting rod as a pendulum. Okay, because we are going to suspend this entire connecting rod at this point, that is Gudgeon pin, and we are going to make a oscillation. Okay, it is just going to, connecting rod is going to make a motion like that. Okay, so it is just going to be swinging about this point. Okay, so it has completed 8 oscillation in 22 seconds. Okay, so we know that the natural frequency of any system can be found by finding the time taken for the number of cycles. Okay, it's going to be cycle per second, or we can put that in hertz. Okay, so the frequency of that given system is 0.3636 hertz. Okay, and we have another standard formula to calculate the natural frequency of a compound pendulum. Okay, so this formula referred to the natural frequency of compound pendulum. Okay, fine. So 1 by 2 pi root of g L1 divided by a square g plus L1 square. Okay, from this formula I can calculate what is the value of kg. Okay, so here the kg value is 0.9028 meter. Okay, so I know the value of L1. Okay, L1 is 1.2 meter, g value is 9.81, and Fn value is formed. Okay, the only unknown is kg. Okay, so the kg value can be formed. Okay, and by using the kg value I can find out the length of the compound pendulum. So this value is needed to find out the torque due to correction couple, that is the equivalent length of the compound pendulum, that is L, okay. K square G plus L1 square divided by L1. So from that I can calculate the value of the equivalent length of the compound pendulum. Okay. So now I've got all the values to calculate the torque 2, okay, which is due to the correction coupled. Okay. So I know the mass of the connecting rod, okay, and L1, and L is the length of the connecting rod, and capital L is the equivalent length of the compound pendulum, and omega value is calculated. Okay. So I know all those values, so I can just apply all those values in this equation, and this torque 2 can be formed. Okay. So now another task is that we can easily find out the magnitude, but what is the direction of the torque? So that is very important. So we know that this torque is applied, okay, by means of applying these two forces. Okay. So this force does not have any torque as far as tanning moment at this point is concerned, okay, because it is not producing any torque, it is applied on that piston, okay, so there won't be any torque at the crankshaft. On the other hand, this force, a part of that correction couple, has certain torque above this point O, okay. So how to find out the direction of the torque? This is the force, okay, and this is the distance. So force multiplied by distance, so what would be the direction of that thing? It is supposed to be in the counterclockwise direction. Force distance about this point, so it's just going to be in the counterclockwise direction. Okay, so now I can just put that direction of the torque due to correction couple is counterclockwise direction. Okay, so now we are going to calculate the torque due to mass placed at the crank pin. Okay, so this is a vertical engine. Okay, the formula is m2gr sin theta. Okay, so here we have to note down this value, okay, that is r sin theta. So what is the mass which is placed at the crank pin supposed to be here? Okay, this is the mass which is placed at the crank pin. So we know that connecting rod mass is going to be divided into two elements. Okay, so one is m1, another one is m2. So m2 is at the crank pin. So now we are going to calculate what is the torque which is created at the crankshaft because of this mass. Okay, there is m2. So what is that weight? m2g. Okay, this is that load. Okay, and the torque can be found by just multiplying this with this resistance r sin theta. So m2g multiplied by r sin theta. For a horizontal engine, it is entirely different. Okay, so it is m2g multiplied by this distance for a horizontal engine, that is m2g r cos theta. On the other hand, for a vertical engine, this term is r sin theta. Okay, so because this distance is r cos theta, so for a horizontal engine, it is going to be m2g into r cos theta. For a vertical engine, it is supposed to be m2g into r sin theta. So this is the formula that we have to remember to calculate the torque due to mass placed at the crank pin. So this is the fundamental thing. It is m2g multiplied by r sin theta, force perpendicular distance. Okay, fine. So for that we need to know what is the part of the connecting rod mass which is placed at the point C. Okay, because we know that the mass of the connecting rod is 250 kilograms, and m1 value is already known. Okay, so as far as dynamically equivalent system is concerned, m1 plus m2 which is equal to mc. Okay, the summation of these two point masses, that is m1 m2, must be equal to the mass of the connecting rod. Okay, so m2 can be found by subtracting this mass from the connecting rod mass, that is 250 minus 100, so m2 is 150 kilograms. Okay, so directly I can apply this value here. It is 150 and G is 9.81 and R is 0.4 meter, and this value is sine 40. Then I can calculate the value of torque due to the mass placed at the crank pin. Okay, the direction of torque due to mass placed at the crank pin can be easily found, because here this weight is acting the downwards direction, so it is acting the downwards direction, and this is the vertical distance, so it is just going to create a clockwise torque. Okay, about this point it's very clear, the force is acting the downwards and the distance is here, so it's just going to create a clockwise torque. So that is why here the torque direction is mentioned as clockwise, okay, for the torque due to the mass placed at the crank pin. Okay, so it is very important to draw the diagram. From that we have to come to a conclusion that whether the torque is clockwise or counterclockwise based on the basic concept. Okay, so now we have calculated that three different torques. Okay, one is due to the piston effort, another one is due to the correction couple, and another one is due to the mass placed at the crank pin. Fine. So now summation of these three torques, it has to be formed to find out the net torque which is applied on the crankshaft. So this is the net torque applied on that crankshaft. Okay, so for that, so I just put negative sign for the torques in which the direction of rotation is counterclockwise, and I just put positive for this torque which is rotating in the clockwise direction. Okay, so the net effective torque applied on the crankshaft is 3812.08 Newton meter. Okay, the next step, I'm just going to remove this sign, okay, because we don't want this sign. So only thing is we need to represent its direction, whether it is clockwise or counterclockwise. Okay, so here which one is dominant? Counterclockwise torques are dominant. So here this net effective torque is going to be in the counterclockwise direction, and its magnitude is 3812.08 Newton meter. Okay, so this is the way that we have to solve the problem. Okay, so thank you.